What's up, guys? Justin, Jekyll and Hyde Athletics here. Heading to the gym. Tuesday morning. A little rainy today. I got bench this morning. So I'll be doing the same kind of thing I was doing yesterday. End up adding a little bit to my top set and doing an extra set and seeing how that works out. And yeah, that's about it today. Feeling good. See how it goes. Hope everybody has a good day today. Make sure you're doing some work towards your goals. And I will see you guys at the gym. What's up, guys? So here we go, starting with the training here. I just put my last sets in here just because this is a long video. There's a lot of coaching towards the end. So what I did was barbell row and then right into my bench and then some ab work afterwards. So got this from Brian Alzeru again. I'll put a link to his channel in here. Felt really good this top set with 280 for 5. So my regular top set was 265, add 5%, 280 for 5. So went really well. Happy with how the bench is moving. And then for the back down stuff, I was doing 5 sets of 10 with 160, so I bumped it up to 205, and I did 3 sets of 8, so you see that after this. I only got one set in there in the video. I did do 3 sets though, so just, you know, a little bit heavier, less volume. That's kind of what I'm going for with this block. And then assistance stuff, I kept the same kind of protocol, so I did a row and a press. So I did dumbbell rows, then dumbbell bench, and dumbbell curls. So get a little extra upper body work, triceps, back, arms. did 3 rounds of this, 10 reps on each one. And then that was it for today. So nice day, good work, feeling really good. And I hope you guys enjoy the training. Please subscribe to the channel. And that's it. What's up, guys? Just got done training. Really good day. Bench and a lot of bench accessory stuff. Trying this new thing out I got from Brian Alzeru again. If you don't know who he is, follow him here and on YouTube too. I think his Instagram is Never Say. I'll tag him. so basically I did rows. I set a row before the bench, then I did the bench, then I did an ab exercise. Really, really cool. I really like it. Did it for my squats yesterday too. Definitely something to get used to, but because I really don't do ab work. I know I should, but usually try to leave it to the end, and then you know what happens when you get to the end. You don't want to fucking do it. So putting it in as like a giant set like that, I think will be very beneficial for people who need to do it, and which is everybody. Everybody needs to do it. So definitely something to try out. Felt really good. So go do something fucking hard today. See ya.
The actual stone. Let's do that. Now, when we start with these smaller ones, it might be a little bit, might be a little bit more difficult just because they're really small and it's hard to, when you get your arms around, you're going to be kind of like this and it'll feel a little awkward, but just to start with. Okay, so you want to be far enough away from the bar or the box so that you're not going to hit your head on it. I see a lot of people kind of come up and like, load sideways. To me, that's very dangerous because you're kind of putting a lateral load on your spine with the stone. I don't really like doing that. So, what I like to do, usually, this is about, you'll figure it out when you do it. If you hit your head a couple times, you'll end up moving backwards. So, as far as standing up over the stone, this part would be easier to see too. So you want to have, I like to have my heels, okay, right in line with the back of the stone. That's going to put you right over the center. If you're too far back, it's going to be way up in front. And obviously, if you're too far forward, it's going to be very awkward to pick. Okay? Okay. So you want your feet to be just wide enough to get your hands in between. You don't want to be super wide. And like I said, you don't want to be behind it. Okay? So heels in line, feet just outside. You're going to come down, spread your hands out. Make sure you get rid of all that first. Okay. You're going to tighten your core up just like you would on a deadlift, okay, before you get down. If you want to kind of get your breath and then go down, or if you want to kind of come down and then like raise your hips up and get your breath, wherever you feel comfortable. Same, I would do the same thing you do for your deadlift.
Okay.
Okay. So come down, fingers nice and wide. You want to get your fingers underneath the stone as far as you can. Okay. Some people do like Vulcan grip, but you don't have to do that. Okay. You can, if on a heavier stone too, if you want, kind of roll it and then roll it back onto your hand.
Gotcha.
That's gonna hurt, but sometimes you gotta do that. Okay, so from there, you wanna be, see how my hips are nice and high? You don't wanna be here.
Yep.
You're gonna have, number one, you're gonna have no power from that position, and you're gonna have a tendency to kind of scoop your arms under, so you wanna lift this with straight arms, or else you're gonna tear your biceps, okay? So you wanna squeeze in as hard as you can, and you're gonna like do an RDL and kind of row it into your lap at the same time. Okay, so from here, you're gonna kind of stand up, row, get it onto your lap, okay? You're gonna move your feet in slightly. Okay, I like to sit down a little bit, get my arms over the top, squeeze in as far, hard as you can. You want it to be nice and high on your chest. Okay, like I said, this is a small stone, so it's hard to kind of do. So from here, what you wanna do is raise your hips up, and then you're gonna do that kettlebell swing. Okay, so you're gonna raise your hips up, and then throw up and over. So on the extension, you want to throw your head back and extend as far as you can all the way up on your toes. If you extend and you're looking at the box or bar, you can tell just standing here. You're not going to get as high as if you pull all the way up.
Okay.
Okay, does that make sense?
I think so. Get my hands on it. And then...
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes it's a little hard to explain, but once you kind of touch it a couple times,
yeah, definitely.
You kind of figure it out. Okay. Make sure your hands are right in the center, so move your, there you go. Squeeze. Yep, good. Don't bend your arms. Roll it in. So sit down. There you go. Like a squat. Yep. Arms more over the top, like 10 and 2. And scoot your feet together slightly. Yep. Good. Like I said, it's going to be a little awkward with a small stone, but. So hips up and then explode forward. Good. Good. Not bad.
It's more on that get it up higher than
these yep. things. Yep. Let's try another. Arms nice and straight. Yep, pick it up, roll. Yep, there you go. Now, yep, sit down all the way, roll it in. Roll it into, yeah, there you go. That's better. And then hips up, explode. Good.
Forward more maybe?
A little bit, yeah. It's okay. Let's do one more, okay? One more and then we'll move up to a heavier stone. It'll probably be easier.
Okay.
Because it's a bigger diameter. That was 115.
Okay.
So this one is 155. So we'll take a little break. I think you got kind of the gist of it a little bit.
Yeah, definitely. One of those things to...
Alright, last one. Thank you.
sure you're in the center. Feet closer. Good. Nice. Feet together. Hips up. Smooth.
Good. There you go. Squeeze. There you go. Nice.
Yeah, wherever. Wherever is fine. Whichever rack you like best.
I don't have a rack
reference.
I've only ever
Let's go, one more.
Huh?
Fine. I need something to get me going.
Squeeze. There we go. Nice. Come on, last one. What's up? Explode. Good.
Hey, you can't laugh over there.
This does not concern you. Okay. So, basically the pick is like a quarter squat, okay? As far as bar position, you're gonna wanna play around a little bit with it, but you're probably gonna be in like a high bar squat position. So you want it to be as high as you can without obviously being right on your spine.
Yep.
Okay, does that make sense?
Yeah, that's usually what I squat.
Okay, I've never really seen anybody be successful carrying like a low bar, you know, like way down on the back like this, because it's just gonna fall off.
Yep. Yeah, usually.
Especially once it gets heavier, obviously.
Okay.
With this one, I like to grab kind of low. Normally, I grab kind of a little bit higher to keep my elbows higher, but this, for some reason, this yoke has two little cutouts here that are extremely sharp, and they just like cut into your hands. So as long as you're grabbing kind of close to it, obviously you don't want to be too close, because when you put it down, you're going to pinch your fingers. Okay. So with this, get your bar position. Okay. Get it nice and high. Okay. You want your upper back nice and tight. Now, me personally, I push out on the yoke, kind of like out and forward. Some people prefer to pull in. That's going to be up to you too, depending on how you feel when you're walking and whatnot. Okay, you want your feet to be right in the center. Okay, if your feet are too far forward, you pick it up, it's going to go backwards. And if your feet are too far back, it's going to be a good morning when you try to pick it up.
Okay,
so you want to be right in the center. You don't want to be super wide either, because if you pick it like this, when you start walking, you're going to be waddling.
Yep.
And as it's going to take you time to bring your feet back together. So obviously, if you're walking like this, the yoke is going to have a tendency to hit the ground and you're going to be very unstable. Okay? So, get under it. Nice and high. Okay? Either push out, pull in. Make sure you're doing something with your arms. You don't want to just be kind of hanging out.
Yep.
Okay, so either way, I like to keep my elbows high, so kind of rotate your elbows up and make like a shelf. Okay? Big breath of air. Pick it up, just like you would a squat. Okay? And then from here, you're going to keep that core nice and tight. You want to keep your head up. You don't want to look down at the ground. Your body has a tendency to follow where you're looking. Okay? And then, so the walking portion, you're almost thinking about pulling forward with your front leg. Okay? So, don't walk backwards. Yeah, so you want to almost feel like you're kind of pulling yourself forward almost.
Okay.
So you're not necessarily like running like a regular walk. Like I said, it's kind of hard to explain. You want to almost think about walking almost like a straight leg. Okay? So you're squeezing your glutes and your core all at the same time. You don't want to, I see a lot of people too kind of bring their feet way up. That's just wasted energy.
Yeah.
So you want to be, you know, heel to toe steps. You want your feet nice and close together. Like I said, you don't want to be out here, and you never ever want to do this because you will fall on your face. Okay? So you want your feet to be as directly under your hips as possible while you're walking. Okay, and like I said, nice shorter steps. You don't want to be taking a big, there's no reason for that.
Okay.
Once you get into it and start going faster, you'll be able to take bigger steps, especially with like lighter weight. But for now, just think heel toe. So short, choppy steps. Okay?
Sounds good.
Let's try and see. Let's see if any of that stuff got through.
Yeah.
Or if I know how to explain anything, we can figure it out.
Just don't cross your legs.
Yeah, don't cross your legs. So you can bring the bar down just a smidge lower on your back, because it looks like to me that you're right on that. You don't want to be right on that bone. Yep. Nice tight core, big air. Good. There we go. Good. Squeeze the glutes, squeeze that core.
Hurts so good.
Yeah, that's what it's supposed to do.
I know.
Big air. Good. Nice tight. Good. There you go. Keep that core nice and tight. Squeeze the glutes. Push out on that yoke. Good. Nice.
Yeah, that's the difference.
Yes. It's it gets heavy very fast.
Yeah.
It's nothing like it's nothing like anything else really.
Yeah.
What's your best squat so far?
Max ever, I think it was like 275. Yeah, and tested them around.
So you can do more weight on this than a squat. Doing this will help your squat too.
Yeah.
Because obviously time under tension on the having that weight on your back is gonna help.
I was feeling in my lower back a little. I don't know if I was like doing stuff like this. Like,
I didn't know. You look like you were pretty straight up and down, but that could be part of it. This is going to, you're going to feel it in places that you hadn't felt it before, just because of so much compression on your spine too. When we're done, we're going to have you hang from the pull-up bar.
Okay.
But if you have access to an inversion table, I don't know if they have one at the other gym they have.
Like, I think like
you know what that is? You hook your feet in and it kind of holds you upside down.
Yeah, no.
That would be ideal, but just hanging from pull-up bar for a couple rounds of 30 seconds should help loosen that up a little bit.
Okay.
I always recommend doing that after yoga, because it is a lot of
compression.
Just like if you think about it too, you spend most of the time is on one foot because you're walking, so it's it's all compression and kind of like twisting a little bit if you're not keeping everything nice and tight. So we'll do, when you're ready, we'll do one more down, and then we'll be done.
Okay.
I don't want to go too crazy. I want to kind of just get you to feel everything.
Yep.
And then, the more come, obviously the more you can increase the weights and do other stuff. So.
What is that? It's not 350?
355. Okay. Look good. Sure. Look really good. Doing the warm-up and stuff, it seemed like you, your movement is pretty good, so.
Cool. Yeah, I try to focus more on form.
Yeah, it's always good idea. You get a lot of people in here that they have a lot of trouble with the hip hinge, the RDL. A couple of people actually had to put them next to the wall and actually make them touch the butt of the wall. It's the only way they can actually get it down. But that looks, you look good. Your hip mobility and ankles look good at the bottom of the goblet, so I don't have any problem with that stuff that I can see. So
John.
Sir.
Should feel a little bit. Guys, heading home here for lunch. Excuse me. Good training this morning. Bench today. Really well. There you go. That's better. Barbell rows first, then the bench, then hanging leg raises. So same kind of little protocol that I did yesterday with the squat, with the, you know, the box jump, and then the ab roller, ab wheel, whatever you want to call it, afterwards. I got that, like I said, I picked that up from Brian Alzeru. Definitely follow him on YouTube and Instagram. I think he's on Facebook too, I'm not sure. Good dude, seems like a good dude, at least I haven't met him. But seems like a good dude, he's got good information. He's definitely strong, he's fucking stronger than me, which makes me angry because I'm bigger than him. Anyways, good work today. I'm liking that. It's kind of similar to the EDT a little bit, as far as working the antagonistic muscle groups, but obviously I'm not doing the time and the weight is a lot heavier, but the results are kind of the same. I felt stronger on the bench after doing the rows, which is counterintuitive, but if you think about it, it kind of makes sense. But we'll see how it works for the next, you know, this block here. I'm going to do that for this block. I'm getting a lot of ab work in, which I know I should do, but I always end up neglecting because it's boring and I don't really like doing it. And I always kind of try to tell myself that I don't need to do it because I do all the strong, like, yeah, you know, typical shit. So it's forced me to do some ab stuff, which I definitely need and most people definitely need. So definitely cool. I said definitely a lot right there. That was like six definitelys in a fucking row. Definitely. Yeah. Anyways, so it went well. A lot of accessory stuff too. And I had a new guy today for strongman training. So you'll see that. He did really well. I was pretty impressed. We did stones and yoke. Worked up to, I think we did the 170 stone for a few sets of three, and then he worked up to 355 on the yoke for a couple runs. I think he told me he's like about 175. He's just getting into strongman. I've been training a little bit, normal gym lifts, but nothing too crazy. So he did really well. So hopefully it continues. I have another strongman person in training. It'll be fun. I guess he was here last week. on a Tuesday or something when I had a dentist appointment, so I wasn't here. So we trained with Matt and did log. So hopefully he keeps coming back. That'd be good. It was really, good training. I love teaching strongman stuff. So as you saw probably already, depending on where I put the clip, I get a little long-winded with explanations of things, especially for strongman. There's a lot of stuff to know. Most people think you just fucking get real big and lift stuff. That's not how it works. So there's a lot of technique to everything, just like anything else. So that's it for now, I think, guys. Damn, that's a big fucking truck. There's a big dumpster in front of me on a truck. It seems awful high too, and usually they're a little bit lower. Hope it doesn't fall on my car. Okay, I'm past it. All right, good, safe. All right, so like I said, I'm heading home, hang out with the kids a little bit. Maybe Jennifer will be home from work before I leave, so that'd be nice to see her. And I'll be back to the JSA around 3 o'clock, 3:30 in that range, to train some more peoples. See what happens as far as people showing up tonight. Hopefully my kids are back. I don't know what the hell happened to them yesterday, but we'll see. So hope you guys enjoy your afternoon, and we'll see you in a little while. What's up, guys? Heading home here, end of the night. Was a long one today, so long video today as well. If you're still here, thank you very much for watching. Appreciate it. And got a lot of stuff, so I got a lot of coaching in here. I was thinking of cutting out some of it, but I don't know. I think it was just good interaction and whatnot. So it was a really long video, and that's fine. Hunter did really well today with the strongman stuff. So we did, like I said, we did stones and yoke, as you saw as well. Worked up to 170 stone for a few sets of three, and then the yoke, I think he did 355 for two or three runs. So pretty good. He told me he weighs about 175, so not bad. First time trying it. Picked it up pretty quick. Looked pretty good doing it, so it was good. It's good to get some strongman people in here. I really like teaching that stuff, so hopefully I get some more in here in the near future. So I hope everybody had a wonderful day today, and I got cardio tomorrow. I'm not sure if I'm going to do a warrior, I'm just going to do some work on the track, some walking and maybe some jog, run, you know, light running. We'll see what happens depending on the weather. If the weather's nice, I'll probably go on the track. I think I need to start doing a little bit more like steady state cardio, just because I'm getting kind of fat again. And yeah, I need to do that. I'm gonna definitely, when Jen and I get back from the wedding in California, I'm gonna try to figure out a way to put jiu-jitsu back into my schedule at least twice a week. So that'll help with that as well. We'll see what happens. So yeah, that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching this far. Please subscribe to the channel so you can see my beautiful face all the time. And Corey, thanks for watching, buddy. How are you? Yeah, that's it for today. So we'll see you guys tomorrow.